Hi guys, welcome back to ChargerLAB. We will show you something different. This is a cellular module, but just the prototype. We all know that iPad has Wi-Fi and cellular module, but the cellular module is much more expensive than the Wi-Fi module, so this cellular module might be another choice. It has two modules. Today we will try to use this one. It comes with USB-C cable. There is a USB-C receptacle at the end of the PCB.So you can browse the web page while charging. And the antenna is connected to PCB via wire and protected by 3M stickers. And the LTE Cat 4 module comes from Quectel EC2008-CN. The charging control IC comes from VIA VL102 and can support BD 3.0. Here is the memory, which comes from Puya P25D40.Turn to back, here is the power supply circuit. This is the socket to connect to the antenna. There is an eSIM card pad in the middle. And here is the physical SIM card slot. Because of the additional USB-C receptacle, so the PCB of Pro model is slightly larger than the standard model. Try to charge the module without connecting any devices. The input power is less than 1 watts. Then connect it to the iPad mini.The standby power is also less than 1 watt. Next, let's see how it works. Firstly, insert a SIM card, then we can see the Ethernet in settings. Here is the name of this module. Now you can browse the web page, watch your favorite YouTube videos, and check the weather on all Wi-Fi versions of iPad. And the overall speed is sufficient. We also tested on MacBook and Windows PC. It can be used normally.We can see the specs of this module on Windows PC. The link speed is 150 megabits per second. Let's use the additional USB-C receptacle to charge the iPad. We've tested on iPad Pro and iPad Mini. It can reach the fastest speed. Then let's use the PC and 16-inch MacBook Pro to test it. We can see that the maximum charging speed of 16-inch MacBook Pro is 60 watts.Which should be the maximum power of this cellular module. For most of the laptops, it's sufficient. And unlike the iPad, the laptop is usually equipped with more than one interface, so the occupied USB-C won't be a problem. As for the connection speed, we tested on speed test, but the specific speed will vary according to your country and region. We do a simple chart to compare different ways of how iPad connected to cellular networks.We can see the cellular module is the most expensive, but easy and convenient. The hotspot is the cheapest, but will quickly drain the phone battery. So the external cellular module can become another new choice. Okay, that's all for today's video. This module is not ready for sale, it's just a prototype. If you're interested in today's video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!